I think there's blame on both sides, and I have no doubt about it, and you don't have any doubt about it either.
Breaking news. America did not see that coming. Good evening, suckers, and those that didn't vote for Trump. Since Trump's recent equivocation on racist violence, it's dawning on Americans, who apparently have been in a white privilege coma since June 15, 2015, that they may have elected a small-fingered Cheeto cracker in a golf cart. Many have demanded that Trump fire Steve Bannon, Sebastian Gorka, and Stephen Miller from his administration. All three are known to have white nationalist ties and xenophobic jackets.
It's mildly okay to be here.
It's Dr. Gorka, okay?
How's my light, okay?
We can see all your sores.
Okay.
Mr. Bannon, you're the first to actually have been fired. How does it feel to be removed from the White House like a Confederate statue?
I'm used to it. I've been a victim all my life, from not getting laid when I was deployed in the Navy, to a wife who wouldn't subjugate herself to me, and to some really bad documentaries I made.
My apologies, Anderson. I didn't expect to see that. I don't think any of us did. I think the problem with liberal America right now is that it feels like a failure and wants to blame their own shortcomings on a small, peaceful minority group of Nazis and white supremacists.
Which just proves once again how these cosmopolitan elites are intolerant, and I, for one, will not tolerate it! Ow!
No.
My bad.
You really gotta get that fixed, Miller.
Oh, dear God. I think that's about all we can take of white nationalists for the moment. Blah. Joining us now is neo-Nazi Christopher Can't Read Well, who marched on Charlottesville recently.
Why are you describing me like that?
As a neo-Nazi?
As marching. You make it sound like we were violent.
You were violent.
I started it!
The people you want to have gassed and lynched started it.
Christopher Can't Read Well, get in here!
Not now, Mom, we're on TV! We're just protesting against white genocide! Nazi lives matter! Free speech, you know? And now people are being mean to us!
Are you crying?
Oh, I got some citronella in my eyes!
What's your mangy dog, Christopher?
God damn it, Mom! Shut the f*** up or else!
Is it wrong to ask for, like, peace and acceptance for our hate group?
Peeing on the duvet, Christopher!
And now you're gonna bleed on it, bitch!
Okie dokie. To talk more about victimhood and the oppression of conservative nutjob speech, we have Ann Coulter and Milo Yappanapadoodle in studio.
I was wondering when you were going to give us the attention we desperately need.
Such a c***, I love you.
I only f*** log cabin Republicans, Milo.
Meow.
Do you two think your appearances at UC Berkeley being canceled somehow sparked this recent wave of open bigotry and hatred?
I hope so. I write about it in my new book.
I write about it also, and better, in my new book. How liberals feel guilty because they secretly want to fuck me.
Why I don't feel guilty secretly wanting to fuck liberals.
Unbelievable. You stole my idea, you little bitch.
Please. Why would I steal from an ossified Tommy Lahren mummy?
Hey!
Harsh.
You try remaining a hot blonde Fox cheerleader when you've rented out your integrity to Breitbart Bukkake for decades.
Okay. Turning to tonight's Deep Dive for Ratings segment, we explore racism and bigotry with David Duke, President Obama, and surprise guest Adolf Hitler.
I was wondering when you were going to give me the attention I so desperately need.
Guten Tag.
I did not know you were pairing me with these two numbskulls.
We do have to compete with Twitter.
Why is a Muslim on the little box?
I knew it.
Adolf, you're in Lake Nahuelwapi, right?
How did you...
Family vacation. It's beautiful there.
Ja, wunderschön.
Pardon me for just a second.
Can we please show some respect to the greatest mass murderer in history and hear what he has to say about the intolerant alt-left oppressing ideas of oppression? Mon Fuhrer, please.
Mr. Hitler, do you have any regrets for creating an abhorrent legacy that continues to crop up in the 21st century?
Nein. It's what the world gets for laughing at my paintings. I was sehr gut. Mein Mutter loved my dog painting.
Oh, shit.
One of the perks of my post-presidency, still get to order drone runs.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go. I got 3,600 tiki torches I gotta return, so...
Should have used Amazon. Finding a pickup truck full of tiki torches in a Home Depot parking lot is pretty easy.
No offense, sir, but you kinda killed this segment.
And I regret that. Drones replaced my cigarette habit. But let me leave you with a Nelson Mandela quote. No one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin, or his background, or his religion. People must learn to hate, and if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love.
Can't you be president again?
With Nazis and the KKK on the rise? Hell no. Obama out.
Coming up, just how f***ed are we? And can Mueller and his investigation unf*** us? And if so, will the Republican leaders in Congress get the f*** off their asses and impeach the white supremacist in the Oval Office before it's too f***ing late? I mean, f***.
Oh.
Fox and Friends in the morning? They're very honorable people. I have nothing to do with Russia. Go fake news.